Good morning, students. Today we are going to continue our lesson 10 Walls Tell Stories. We were seeing about the Golconda Fort. Here the map is given. See what are the places are located and where it is located, in which position, that is in north, west, east and south. So in these places, what all present they have given, by using this map we can find out what type of places are present in Golconda Fort. Listen here one picture is given. What does this picture means? While these friends are talking, that time Sridhar called up to see a big gun. See here, a big gun is located here. That is what we call it as cannon. And we ran up the steps and they were seeing. First, Sailesh is saying, this must have been the Sultan's big gun. I think so, like the child just saying. For that, Didi is replying that, no, this was used by Aurangzeb. His full army came with their guns and cannons to attack. For 8 months, they were camped outside the fort. By using this gun only, they were planning to attack the king inside the Golconda fort. So, Shail just saying, why should the army come here all the way from Delhi? So, Didi is explaining that in those days, kings actually play their tricks to capture the smaller kingdom as they are part of their own kingdom. And it may be done using the friendship or sometimes by flattery. Flattery means faking the person, or even by marriage between families. And when nothing else worked, they also attacked them. Kalyani is saying, why is it that Aurangzeb's army could not get into this fort? He had so many soldiers and big guns. Kalyani is asking, see, there are many soldiers or him with that Aurangzeb army, and big gun is having. Why he didn't enter into the fort? He can able to enter, no? So Shailja is replying that, did not you see the strong thick walls in the map? There is a long deep ditch along the wall. How could the army enter? She's saying, have you not seen that Golconda Fort map? In that map, not only a big wall is present, even a big pit is present, so they cannot able to enter there. Sridhar is saying, if the army tried to come from a different side, then the soldiers in the Basiton would have seen it from a distance. No wonder it was difficult to attack the fort. Imagine, the army is coming on horses and elephants with all their guns. Here the Sultan army starts fully prepared. Kalyani is saying, you can imagine that in film, many army will be coming and the king will be ready to ensure them. Same voice here also, Sultan army is very, very prepared to protect them. Oh no, how many people and soldiers are on both the sides must have been killed in all this fighting. Why do people attack and have wars? Why they are doing like this? They can be calm, no? Why they are making like this fighting? It's very, very unfair, like that Sailesh is saying. Now, Sridhar is replying that guns and cannons are things of the past now. These days, many countries have nuclear bombs. Single bomb can cause so much destruction. Now, these guns and cannons are all not using in many of the countries. They are using only a nuclear bomb. That one nuclear bomb made so much destruction and can make also, like the Sridhar is saying. And see here, discussing, you can discuss that, have you recently read or heard about any country attacking or going to war with any other country? And you can find out the reason, what is the reason for this war? Why, what kind of weapons were used in this war? What kind of destruction happened because of that war? You can find it out. And many other questions also given related to this. In that time,
how they arranged for the water we are going to see. The picture also they have given. See, look out here. The picture shown here is made after seeing a very old painting of those days. After seeing the painting of those days only made this picture. Can you think why bullocks have been used here? Use your hand movement to show in which direction the drum attached to the rod moves when the bullocks move. In which direction would the tooth wheel move? So what direction it actually moves? See, they have shown the direction. See here, the wheel is moving in this direction and the opposite direction bullocks are moving. So that only they can pick the water. Look here, this pole shown under the ground joins with another wheel which has a number of pots on it. From this also they are getting. Now imagine he would this garland of pots lift water from the well. See, from this only they are lifting the water from the well, joining here and they are lifting the water from the well. Do you now get some idea about how the tanks could have been filled up lifting water from the wells? Even today we can see clay pipes in the walls of the fort. These pipes would have been used to carry water to different places in the palace. Even now also like this type of pipes are present. Through this only they are carrying water to the different places in the palace, they are saying. Okay. Where else have you seen such wheels attached to each other? For example, we can see in the cycle or somewhere else. Here and all we can see like this type of wheels. Look around and find out how water is pumped up from the ground to higher places. See, those days they were using the bullock cart, but nowadays we are using a pipe and motor and the water is transferred to the different places from a single area. You can find it out in your place also how you are getting the water. That also you can write it down. How is water pumped by using electricity? How is water lifted without electricity? You can answer for these questions. See here, what a sad sight. What sad sight means this is talking, whistling and listening to our own echo. We were walking through this makarab. Makarab means it's like a arc. Here we can hear our own voice. Shrida saying, oh, the breeze feels so cool in this tunnel. It's very, very cool, like that he is saying. And in that it was written that soldiers stayed here, like that there have been written. See this broad, but look what the wall is like. Something's written. Writing on the wall is prohibited, like that they have written. Oh, think how this wall has been thousands of years go by. It has seen kings and queens, horses and elephants, war and peace. But we have spoiled in just a few years, we have spoiled this one. I don't understand what kind of fun do people get in writing their names all over the place like this. Is it looking nice? I don't like this, like that Kalyani is saying. Close your eyes. Go back in time. Imagine that you are in those days when there was a busy town inside Kolkata. Think about the questions given below and discuss in class. You could even put up a play. See, you are thinking that you are in the Kolkata place and imagine what had happened and you can answer for this question. What is the Sultan doing in this palace? You can just imagine and you can answer for this question. What he may be during those days? What comes your mind? Just you can write it. What kind of clothes is he wearing? What dishes are being offered to him? But why does he seem so worried? And in what language is he talking? Imagine the rooms in the palace, the beautiful carpets and curtains, the fountains on the terrace and the sweet smell of roses and chamomile. Where is this coming from? Just you imagine, where these are all coming from? What are the different kinds of factories you can see here? How many people are working there? So many questions are arising in our mind. See here, a picture of the objects recovered during that place they have given.
going to the museum. After seeing Golconda, the children also went to a museum in Hyderabad. Many old items in museum, what they be kept in? Old items for the remembrance, they will be kept in here. Many things were found when the place around Golconda was dug, like pots, jewelry, swords, etc. they have found here. Sailja is saying, oh, why are these broken pieces of pots kept in the Almeric? See that small plate made of bronze? That blue piece seemed to be made of ceramic. Why these things and all they are keeping here like that? Sailja is asking. Didi is saying, it is through all these things we come to know that how peoples are lived here, what type of materials they have used. If all this would not have been kept here, how would you know so much about those times? Make your own museum. You can make your own museum. See, Rajni teaches in a government school in Malappuram district in Kerala. Together with the children of her class, she has collected many old things from all the houses, like old walking sticks, locks, umbrellas, wooden slippers, pots. They also saw what these things look like today. Rajni and the children put up an exhibition which people from the neighborhood came to see. You could also do this. You can also collect some old coins or old things which are available for you, and you can make it as a museum so that other children also can look that one. Other people also come to know, oh, this type of things were used those times. It will be very, very useful for you and also other people. See, look at the painting until. This painting is 500 years old painting. It shows Agra Fort being constructed. During the construction time, that painting has been taken. What kinds of work are people doing? How many men and women are working here? See how they are taking the huge pillar up along the slope. Is it easier to lift a heavy thing straight up or along a slope? Were you able to see the man carrying water in a mazak leather bag? Okay, students, related to this lesson, I'll send you a Google form test. Attend it. All the best. We'll meet in the next class.